Dit is Radio 6.
Hello, Mr. Gregory Porter. Welcome to Radio 6. How are you?
I'm great, man.
Yes?
I've been traveling a lot, but it's good to be home. Yeah, I said
yes?
Home.
Does it feel like home a little bit
it
to
does.
Be in Holland?
Y'all been good to me here. Yeah.
Yeah. I was wondering, is it, you know, sometimes people that are sort of huge in Holland, mm-hmm. sometimes they're huge in Denmark and mm-hmm. huge in France, and then overseas back in the States, they're not as big.
Yeah.
Do you have any sort of the comparison? Can you say, well, I'm more successful in Denmark than in Holland, or I'm only successful in Holland and the States are coming by, or are you big in the States too?
Well, I would say in France and the UK and in Holland. My name is swelling.
Yeah.
And it is growing in the United States as well after some couple of Grammy nominations. And
that helps.
Yeah, people kind of, you know. Well, I will tell you what happened.
Well,
I was nominated next to Beyonce for Best Traditional R&B.
Mm-hmm.
So people was like, "Who is this guy?"
Yeah.
Okay. and then they found me that way. So
yeah.
However it be.
Yes, we met a couple of years ago when, well, you were still relatively unknown in Holland. Yeah. We sort of said, who's this guy? Oh, somebody wrote something nice about him. Well, let's get him in the studio. And me and my co-host Koen, our jaws just dropped when you sang with Chip on the piano. I remember very well.
Yeah.
And we were so pleased to have you in the studio. A lot of things have happened to you since then. What I was wondering is, how has this success affected your life? Because that is a big change in your life when success comes along knocking on the door.
Yeah, well, a lot of interviews, mm-hmm. a lot of time on the road, a lot of steaks. You know, I've been eating steaks every night.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's been beautiful, man. Just the ability to express myself musically and try to get out to the world. I used to feel crazy saying that. Get out to the world.
Mm-hmm.
These different expressions of love, you know. So it feels great, man. It feels great.
So could you recommend success to everybody?
I would recommend a little taste of it. If you can handle it. I can handle it. I mean, you know.
Yeah.
I know what to do with the little change I'm getting, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, that's very good to know. Okay, tonight you're also playing at the North Sea Jazz Club in Holland.
Yeah.
And today with the Metropolitan. Which are you nervous for either one of these gigs?
I've worked with the Metropole Orchestra at Paradiso.
Yeah.
I didn't think they could fit the whole band in there, but we squoze in there with a great crowd, and it was a wonderful experience. So no, that's why I say I feel like I'm coming home, because you know I just had to hug, you know, 60 people. Just
yes.
Like, oh, good to see you. Oh,
yeah,
see
yeah.
You.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you're not nervous for a gig like tonight, North Sea Jazz Club.
No, I tell you, I only get nervous when you know, when I just get a song 30 minutes before it's time to go on stage, you know.
And say, do this.
Sometimes that happens.
Yeah?
But I'm a little nervous. You know, standing next to Anthony Hamilton, he's an extraordinary talent in history, but in the music today, he is. And working with Gretchen Parlato, she's always been beautiful. And yeah.
Okay. I'm going to make you a little nervous.
Okay.
Have you heard this song before? Do you know it?
Yes.
Let's listen to it for a while, okay? And it's the vocalist is Pharrell.
Yes.
You know him.
Yeah.
Let's listen to it.
Like the legend of the phoenix, all ends with beginnings.
Okay. That's a big summer hit all over the world. Get Lucky by Daft Punk, featuring Nile Rodgers on guitar and Pharrell. And I was wondering, you know, this is like a pop song.
Yeah.
And would it be possible to jazz that song up?
Absolutely.
Yeah. How would you go about, how would you do that?
I tell you, while Pharrell is singing, I would dance around him. No, not dance. I mean, musically dance around him like Wayne Shorter.
Okay.
Like Wayne Shorter does on his saxophone.
All right. Now,
you can play the song, I'll show you what I'm talking about.
Yeah, okay. That's what I wanted to ask you. Here is Daft Punk, Get Lucky, and here is Gregory Porter with it.
Like the legend of the phoenix.
The legend of the phoenix.
All ends with beginnings.
Ending with beginning.
What keeps the planet spinning?
What keeps the planet spinning?
Yes, here's the chorus.
She's up all night to get lucky. I'm up all night to get strong. She's up all night to get lucky. I'm up all night to get
Did you say rip that banana?
No, I didn't say rip that banana.
Rip that banana.
That's a good one. Yeah. Rip that banana. I didn't say that. It's a cool groove.
Yeah, yeah. No, that's
so. It can be done.
It can be done, man.
Yeah,
it can be done.
And you know, I was one last question before we going to listen to one of your live tracks from last year is, you know, you're supposed to be. People call you a jazz singer, and jazz is a way of life. I always think, you know. So, do you take certain elements of jazz music in daily life? Do you use them? Is there a way to use to lead a jazzy life?
Actually, yes, man. When that lyric passes through me, Nat King Cole's lyric, the greatest thing you'll ever learn is just to love and be loved in return. I have a song on my next album, Liquid Spirit, called When Love Was King. And there's a part in there, and it's kind of political. It's like, he lifted up the underneath, and all his wealth he did bequeath to those who toiled without a gain, so they could remember his reign when love was king. So that's like giving to the poor, feeding the hungry. You know, these things, which I get to sing, are also my belief system, and they come through me. So, I use it every day, every day. He lifted up the underneath, and all his wealth he did bequeath. I watched a 6-year-old Indian boy who wasn't allowed to go to school. It was 10-year-old. Mm-hmm. Indian boy wasn't allowed to go to school. He had to make bricks all day from sunup to sundown.
Yeah.
And I had just been working on that song, When Love Was King. He lifted up the underneath and all. The underneath is those people who are on the underneath. And so I got to that part of the song and I started crying thinking of this boy. It's so real, man. It's so real. It's so real. I don't mean to bring nobody down.
No. But we could use some more love.
Yeah. So when this music, though we can groove to it, there's still you can throw a little message in there.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how soul music was in the 70s, man. Somebody was always talking, singing about Mama. Oh, she was so good, you know.
Yeah.
Sadie, you know. So I think that same thing should come around again, man. You know, he lifted up the underneath, and all his wealth he did bequeath. Bam.
And that's that. Something that you do every day, Mr. Gregory Porter. Thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you.